So in terms of paintings, we're actually starting with something that doesn't look like a Kandinsky, if you're familiar with him at all. This is A Motley Life, and this is actually a very early work by the artist. So this is his attempt at an ethnographic study. He's showing religion mixed with paganism in northern Russia. He's being sent out to study these people. He's really going out to study them effectively as an anthropologist. And while he's there, he's doing these paintings to kind of study the people, to remember the experience, a number of different possibilities. And it's actually a very detailed work, but we start to see some of that simplification of form that Kandinsky is going to be particularly known for. Look at the brushwork. Look at how simple the coloration and use of tone is. There's no blending. There's no modeling. Here, the figures have no mass. They are strictly two-dimensional. Now, where this becomes important, and the only reason I bring this painting up, is because we want to look at the study for composition 2, which is based on A Motley Life. This is actually an abstraction of the previous work, or at least parts of the previous work. Now let's talk about abstraction for a moment and how Kandinsky looks at abstraction, because he sees it as simplification. So as we compare the two, we see that simplification. The forms are there, the figures are there, the hill in the background is still there, the church, or at least the idea of the church. So here's our hill with the castle in the middle. Here's our hill with the castle. Here's a group of people. Here's our group of people. So it's not one for one, but you're definitely getting the same idea back and forth. Now, when he looks at abstraction, he's actually, and this is by Picasso, but it gets across the idea, he's basically simplifying the form. So here we see a series of cows as they go through stages being simplified to more and more basic forms. And that's what Kandinsky is doing. He's taking the original form, and in Motley Life, he's kind of at the first stage here where he's made it flat and two-dimensional, and he's spreading, he's moving along this spectrum to more and more abstract forms. And in fact, he will move one step further. So this cow to him might be something like this with a U on it, and that is your cow. You know, just a simple form like that could be a cow to Kandinsky. So when we look at this work, we start to see that abstraction take place. And if we actually were to line up all of his pieces, you would see that abstraction forming. An idea that we're going to get to